फ्रेंड्स, हम लोग अब देखेंगे थ्योरी ऑफ स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन एज गिवन बाय मैक्स वेबर। मैक्स वेबर वाज अ जर्मन सोशियोलॉजिस्ट एंड ही गेव दिस थ्योरी, सोशल स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन थ्योरी, इन एन एसे टाइटल्ड क्लास स्टेटस पार्टी। एंड दिस एसे वाज पब्लिश्ड इन हिज बुक वर्शाफ एंड Jessel Shaft. So, as we have seen that the title, as the title of this essay show, class status party. His theory of stratification consisted of these three themes: class, status, and party. So, let us come and see how Max Weber defined the term class. Weber says that social stratification basically results from struggle for scarce resources. The resources in society are scarce. People fight for that, and this fight leads to social stratification. And this struggle, fight among the people, is mainly concerned with the economic resources in society. Economic resources like house, like factory, like road, like land, etc. But this struggle is may not be just confined to economic resources in society, but it may also be for prestige, honor. It may also for acquisition of political power. So people in society may be fighting, struggling for economic resource, for prestige and honor, and for political power. And these three things corresponds with Max Weber's title of this essay, Class, Status, Party. So like Karl Marx, Max Weber also defined class in economic terms. He gives a definition of class. He says, class is a group of people, group of individuals, who share similar position in market economy. So these people have similar situation, similar status condition in the market economy, and they receive similar economic rewards. So a person's class situation is basically his market situation. What is his class? You can come to know what is his situation, what is his value in the market. Max Weber, like Karl Marx, said that there were basically two major category of class. One was the people who own the means of production, the rich people, the capitalist, and those who did not, the poor people, the landless, the people who worked in the factories. So this is the major classification of a class. Those who owned the means of production, those who owned factory, they offered goods and products. Like the people who owned a factory of medicine, they would provide, they would sell medicine to the market. On the other hand, we have another group of people who do not own any means of production. They do not own any land or factory. So these people, what do they do? They sell labor, they sell their labor power, they sell their skills. So Max Weber's theory of stratification revolves around these people. He finds that the people who do not own means of production, and the people who sell their skills and labor skills, etc., the situation is a bit complex. It is not the way Karl Marx explained. He says that propertyless group face different market situation, because you have people with different type of skills. A doctor, he does not own means of production. A lawyer, a professor, a person who cleans the road, they all of them do not own means of production, but They do not form one category of people, not one class of people. Their market situation, their condition, their value, importance actually varies. So Max Weber discusses about this category of people. Max Weber next stresses the importance and stresses the life chances as an aspect of class. So, what is the life chance? Life chance is the opportunity which an individual will have in his life. For example, a person who works in a factory as a laborer, he will have different life chance from an engineer who takes degree from a technical institute and works in a multinational company. They will have different life chances because they have different opportunities in the market in their life. So, Max Weber says that life chances of an individual were largely determined by the market situation. Max Weber tells us two basic things about class. One, whether one owns the means of production or not. One is the owner of a factory or not. So that is one thing. So whether he is a propertied class or propertyless, propertied group or without property. And the second thing he talks about is life chance. So all the member, he says that all the members of a particular class have similar life chances. And these life chances actually distinguish these members from the other group. So therefore, when the people who do not own the means of production, they have different life chances. So taking into account these things, Max Weber classified classified the capitalist society in four classes, in four categories. They are upper class, those who own the means of production. There is a white collar working class. They engage in mental labor. They are manager, administrator, professionals, etc. Then you have petty bourgeoisie class. They are self-employed people, for example, the shopkeeper. And lastly, the fourth category is that of manual working class. It is the people who work, give as a laborer, and give their labor in exchange for wages. So these are the four classes which Max Weber talks about. Next aspect of Max Weber's theory of stratification is status. So Max Weber says that class is not the only basis for group formation, for collective action, or for acquisition of power. There are other bases. There can be other bases. And another base is status group. That was class group, and this is status group. People belonging to one status group. So this is also a basis of group formation. So what is a status group? It is made up of individuals who share equal social honor. So people belonging to a status group, they have equal social honor. These people are also aware of their common life situation. Like we have learned that the people belonging to a class have class consciousness. They have awareness that they belong to a class. Similarly, people belonging to a status group do have awareness of their common status situation. The people belonging to a status group have also similar lifestyle. And these people also place restriction that the outsiders do not interact with them or enter into their group. So we have example of a caste, The caste of one caste would place restriction on the other people from entering into their caste group. So, in many societies, class and status situations are closely linked. The people who are at the top in the status group, they are also top in the class ranking. The rich people belonging to the higher castes. So, next point is poverty is not always recognized as a status qualification, but in the long run, it is. Person who is the people who rank high in a status do have lots of money. And the next point is that those who share the same class situation may not belong to the same status group. Suppose a group of people become rich and they go high in class, but they would not be accepted as people belonging to the highest status group. Suppose a group of people who belong to caste XYZ, they acquire XYZ and they have low status, caste-wise lower status, and they acquire money, they become rich. So they would go high in the class ranking, but their status in the caste hierarchy would not rise. So Max Weber says that those who share the same class situation actually may not belong to the same status group. Thus, status is associated with a lifestyle, social honor, prestige, with the consumption which this group of people do. It also places restriction on social intercourse with other group of people. It says that Weber says that India's caste system is the most rigid and well-defined example of status group. And then we come to party, the third leg of Max Weber's theory of social stratification. He first defines parties. He says that party is a group or concerned with influencing policies and decision and making decision in the interest of their members. So a political party would basically be influencing the policy of the government, and it will also be making decision in the interest of its member. Next, parties are generally concerned with acquisition of social power. Max Weber says that parties generally represent interest of a class or interest of a status group. You take a political party, and that political party would be actually working for the benefit of a particular class of people, rich people, middle class people, or lower class people, or it may be working for the interest of a particular caste or a status group. But in many cases, a political party may be representing the interest of neither a class nor a status group. This is also possible. Next, Max Weber says that the relationship between a political group, political party, and the class and a status is not very clear cut. It's not that a political party would be always and in all cases working for the interest of a particular class or a particular status group. It is muddled, and we have different kind of situations. And the same point he again makes, that parties can divide and cut across both classes and status group. That is, a political party populated by rich people may be working for the interest of the poor people, or political party which is run by, controlled by a particular caste, suppose higher caste, may be working for the interest of the lower caste. That is the conclusion of Max Weber. Thus, to conclude, Karl Marx reduced all form of inequality to classes. And